Hello students, today we shall discuss about life process. These are the some key points of life process. What is life process? The process that are necessary for an organism to stay alive. For example, nutrition and respiration is required for a life process, because those two are the more important process in which the organisms are very needed. Criteria of life. What is a life? Having a growth and a movement of an organs or a body parts is a main criteria of a life. What is life? Any organism which has growth, development and other metabolic activities is called a life. What is nutrition? The process in which an organism takes in food and utilizes it to get energy for growth and repair and maintenance. Here repair means the immunity power or the resistance for diseases, etc. And excretes the waste materials from the body. This is a nutrition. What are the types of nutrition? As we seen yesterday, here first type is autotrophic nutrition. In this, auto means self, tropes means nourishment. Nourishment means having a food or intaking of food. For example, plants, algae and blue green bacteria. How plants prepare their food? With the help of photosynthesis. Here photo means light, synthesis means to combine. What are the raw materials which are required in the process of photosynthesis? Carbon dioxide and water. This is a equation of photosynthesis. Carbon dioxide plus H2O means water. Carbon dioxide in the presence of water with the sunlight, with the help of chlorophyll. Chlorophyll is a green color pigment. Gives rise to a glucose and oxygen. Here energy consumption table. Role of chlorophyll. What is the role of chlorophyll? To trap the sun's energy from the for photosynthesis. What happens with the chlorophyll? Chlorophyll is a pigment which attracts or receives light and it produces heat to burn the trapped food or intaken food. Events or steps of photosynthesis. What is the events or steps? Absorption of light energy by chlorophyll. Conversion of light energy to chemical energy. What happens here? In the presence of sunlight, the light is converted into chemical energy. What is the chemical here? Glucose. And the splitting of water molecule into hydrogen and oxygen. In the reaction, what we see is H2O. H2O, what happens here? Splitting of hydrogen and oxygen. In glucose, 1H will come and oxide, it is a separate. We get as a gas molecule. And reduction of carbon dioxide to carbohydrate. Reduction of carbon dioxide, CO2 here. This gives rise to a carbohydrate. It is a glucose. And gaseous exchange. Gas is which gas is used? Carbon dioxide. And the byproduct gives rise to oxygen. This is a byproduct. What is the source of raw material? Carbon dioxide means it presents in land or air or aquatic elements or water. Next, water and minerals is soil. Next, second step is heterotrophic nutrition. Here we see hetero means others. Tropes means nourishment, means giving a nutrition or intake of food. Lacking of chlorophyll like fungi means here there is a lack of chlorophyll pigment. So these organisms, they depend upon other organisms for their food purpose. In this, first step is saprophytic nutrition. here, organisms feed on dead decaying plants or animal material is called a saprophytic nutrition. For example, fungi and bacteria. Second one is parasitic nutrition. Organisms obtained their food from the body of another living, means here these parasites, they live in other organism only as a host. They consider the other organism as their host. Here there are two types, endoparasites and exoparasite. Parasite lives inside the body of host is called a endoparasite. Example, tapeworm. Tapeworm lives in a human being stomach and a roundworm. Exoparasite here is parasite lives on the body of other host. For example, leech and the lice. Note, this is a point. The parasite benefits while the host is usually harmed. Cruciata plant or a Plasmodium vivax. This, what happens is, this doesn't harm other organism, but this harms its own colony. Next, C type is holozoic nutrition. Organisms take in whole food and the digestion into smaller particles with an enzyme. Means what they do is they take the whole food of other organisms and what they will do is they will cut into small particles with the help of some enzymes. For example, here amoeba is an organism and paramecium. Steps involved in holozoic nutrition is ingestion, digestion, assimilation and digestion. Ingestion means intaking of food. Digestion means breaking down of food particles into smaller particles and in a absorbable form, means it should dissolve or solved into our blood or any organisms. Assimilation, here assimilation means utilization of digested food from the body. Assimilation means utilization, means use of digested food particles from the body. Ejection means removing of undigested food from the body. Today we shall see a new topic. This is elementary canal. Now elementary canal, it is a human digestive system. Here the parts are mouth, esophagus, stomach, small intestine, large intestine and rectum. In a mouth, digestion begins in the mouth. What happens in the mouth? Chewing takes place and the food is converted into bolus. Later it moves to esophagus. The following process takes place in the mouth. What happens? Teeth cuts the food into small bits. What happens? The complex food particles are converted into simpler micromolecules. What happens here is macromolecules are converted into micromolecules. Next, what happens? Saliva softens the food to the pulp. This process is called a bolus. Saliva softens the food to the pulp. With the help of saliva, what happens? The food is attached to saliva and it is converted to bolus. Bolus is a round food body which is easy to move to the esophagus. Next, tongue helps to push the bits of food into the throat or a food pipe. This is a process which takes place in mouth. Next, we have seen esophagus. In the esophagus, food pipe, the wall of esophagus expands. What happens here? This throat will be in a thin structure. After entering the food, it will expand, means opening of food pipe, and relaxes, which make the wave-like reaction to push the food into stomach. In the stomach, what contains main chemical is HCl. most of the food gets digested in the stomach and intestine. In the stomach, it secretes digested juices like gastric juices, which breaks protein to amino acids. Here, protein is converted to amino acid. Hydrochloric acid kills the germs and action of enzymes. Here, HCl, what the process of HCl is? It kills the germs. And food converted to semi-solid state called chyme. Next is small intestine. In the small intestine, food mixes with bile juice. Bile juice is secreted by liver and pancreatic juices. Then enters into a small intestine. It gets mixed with the intestinal juices, which contains enzymes that helps in digestion. Proteins, amino acids, and bile juice, main components of small intestine. Fat and fatty acids. Fat is converted to fatty acids, glycerol by intestinal juice. Simple sugars by pancreatic juices. What happens here is glucose is converted to simple sugar under pancreatic juices. Finger-like projections called villi, which absorbs nutrients. From this, it circulates to all parts of our body. Next we see is large intestine. The leftover liquid mixture of undigested food and water in the small intestine is proceeded into the large intestine. The walls of a large intestine allow the water and leftover usable substances to pass back into the blood. What happens here is the leftover particles, means which is undissolved or undigested particles, are moved to the blood. The moist undigested solids remain inside, means that is next moved to the rectum. The rectum muscles create a pressure that helps in removing the solid waste as a excretory part. These are the organs, glands, enzymes with juices and their function. Let's see one by one. First organ is mouth. In the mouth, which gland? Salivary gland is secreted. Which is the enzyme? Salivary amylase. And what is the function? Converts starch into a sugar. Means in mouth, the gland secreted is salivary glands. Here chewing through the stairways with the help of salivary amylase and it is converted to sugar. Next one is stomach. In the stomach, gastric glands are secreted. Like enzymes, say gastric juices. First one is hydrochloric acid, pepsin and mucus. Here hydrochloric acid, what it will do is, it kills harmful bacteria that enters with the food. And makes the medium alkaline for action of pepsin. Next juice is pepsin enzyme. It's a digesting protein. Next, mucus protects the inner lining of a stomach from the corrosive action of a hydrochloric acid. Hydrochloric acid pH rate is very much high inside the stomach, so it should be protected by layer. This mucus is a layer which protects the stomach lining. Small intestine. Next part is small intestine. This is liver. As I told, liver secretes bile juice. Makes the medium acidic for action of pancreatic enzyme. And breaks down the large fat molecules into smaller globules. So that enzyme can act upon them. Okay. Next one is pancreas. Pancreas means pancreatic juices. Here what? Amylase, trypsin, lipase. Amylase, what it will do? It converts carbohydrates to glucose. And trypsin, converts protein to amino acid, and lipase converts fat into fatty acids. This what of all elementary canal. From next class, we shall start with respiration.